This is called the KC-97 Strato Tanker. It was purchased by the Air Force in 1953. This particular aircraft was used for refueling. It was used for refueling propeller-driven aircraft as well as jet aircraft. This actually had four engines on it, propeller-driven, and what was one of the issues with it was that because it was propeller-driven, it could only go so fast. So as the jet age started to grow and more jet aircraft came around, the issue was this couldn't fly as fast as the jets could. So it became an issue for refueling because the jet aircraft would pull up and they couldn't slow down enough to get fuel. So they actually took a variation of this aircraft and put jet engines out on the very tips of the wings. So when they were refueling jets, they'd fire up those jets to make it go faster so that the jets could refuel, then they'd turn them off and then the jets would go away. But eventually this was replaced by an all jet aircraft because it was just too slow. It was interesting because it was one of the first of the double decker aircraft. So you have this part of the fuselage, but then underneath here from this lip on, there was another level and it actually had two floors. So it was a double decker aircraft. On the freighter and the refueling version, they used that for freight and fuel. On the actual version that they use for passenger commercial flights, they actually used that for a lounge. They had a cocktail lounge in the bottom and you'd go down the staircase into the lounge and you could sit in the chairs down there. It was a smoking lounge. You could smoke and have a drink and be downstairs while the passengers were sitting upstairs.
So what will people be able to see when they come out to the Raptor Center during the month of November?
So what we have is you'll be able to enter in the back and be in the cargo area. So there's a very large cargo area that you walk into, and then you'll be able to move up to the front and look into the full cockpit area. So this aircraft in particular had four different flight crew. You had the pilot, you had a co-pilot, you had a flight engineer, and you had a navigator. In today's aircraft, there really are only two, a pilot and a co-pilot, and the other two jobs are taken over by the computer systems. But in this particular aircraft, it was four people that actually operated the aircraft. So they'll be able to look into the cockpit area and see all the controls. It's fully restored that you can see all the controls and all the seats and everything as it was in 1953 to fly.
Thank you so much, and thanks to Carolina's Aviation Museum for bringing this wonderful plane out to the Carolina Raptor Center for Flight Fest.
You're welcome. Thanks for having us.